Hi everyone. Today we will see 5 more current affairs which will be easy for you to revise and recollect during this pandemic. Before that, I will be giving you a task on Thirukkural, that is Pagal Vellum Kugai Kaakai Igal Vellum Vendarku Vendum Bozhudhu. The previous Thirukkural's Tamil and English version is given here. Make use of it. Let's go. The first one is Aditya L1 mission. It is first Indian mission to study the sun under ISRO. Already US has done that. So it is placed in the halo orbit, that is around L1 point in the Sun Earth system, between the Sun Earth system. So the major advantages about Aditya L1 mission is about viewing the Sun without any occultations or ellipses. A clear view will be there and inserted in the halo orbit around L1, which is 1.5 million kilometers from the Earth, and it also carries its payloads with technological advancements to clearly view the Sun's corona, chromosphere and photosphere. Okay, outer surface, chromosphere and the photosphere. So the particle payloads will be there. That is 6 advanced science and technology equipments will be there to study about the corona, chromosphere and photosphere. Among the 6, magnetometer payload will measure the variation in the magnetic field strength, which is around L1 point, Lagrangian point. And these have to be placed outside the interference from the Earth's magnetic field, because to get the continuous and clear observation, and it will not be useful in the low Earth orbit of around 2000 km. Okay. Next, tiger corridors. Already we have tiger reserves in our country of about 50. Recently in Chhattisgarh, Boramdev sanctuary, wildlife sanctuary is also to be announced as tiger reserve soon. Yet not confirmed. Statutory body, that is National Tiger Conservation Authority, in collaboration with Wildlife Institute of India, it is an autonomous organization and MOFCCC, has published a document titled Connecting Tiger Populations for Long-Term Conservation. It will be mapping out 32 major corridors across the country, and it will be operationalized through the Tiger Conservation Plan, that is Project Tiger, and mandated under Wildlife Protection Act 1960. Here I am giving you only the landscapes, that is Shivaliks and Kanchatik Plains, Central India and Eastern Ghats, Western Ghats and Northeast. 32 corridors considered about important tiger reserves like Dudhwa, Karpet, Indravadi, Simlipal in Odisha. Like these major tiger reserves are considered here, like Kanha also. Rudyard Kipling's Jungle Book has been written based on that, no? That's all. So just to have a glance through 32 tiger corridors. So because tigers always migrate from one place to the other across the borders, so that's why tiger corridors has been adopted. So 3-pronged strategy used is material and logistic support to the tiger reserves and restricting the habitat interventions and also standard operating procedures. So what is the standard operating procedures means? During emergency, due to the straying of the tigers in human dominated landscapes, they will deal with the tissues and the tiger depredation on livestock when they enter into the human habitat places, and for also rehabilitation of tigers from the source areas. Also, India's Tiger Census Report 2018 has been awarded the Guinness World Record. So please make note of the NTCA Project Tiger again. Next one is 4 new species have been added under the Species Recovery Program. So this is added by National Board for Wildlife under the Species Recovery Program for the critically endangered species on the recommendation of the Standing Committee. So they are the Northern River Terrapin, Clouded Leopard, Arabian Sea Humpback Whale and Red Panda. Please remember the IUCN status of these animals, because they may ask you in terms of choose the incorrectly matched and all. Okay, they have asked already. So the Integrated Development of Wildlife Habitat, which was included during the 11th 5-year plan, the MOEFCCC, that is Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, has put forward this program for the recovery of species under greatest threat. Okay, so it is one of the 3 components of the centrally funded scheme. It is a centrally sponsored scheme, that is Integrated Development Wildlife Habitat. So they will give support to the protected areas like national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, conservation reserves, community reserves, and also outside the protected areas, and also recovery them. So the 17 species which was already under the Species Recovery Program are Snow Leopard, Bustard, Kanchatik River Dolphin, Hungul, Nilgiri Tar, Marine Turtles, and we have already seen about Bustard and all 4 species are in India.
And dugongs, edible nests of flood. It is a nocturnal bird. Asian wild buffalo, Nicobar megapod. It is a state bird of Andaman Nicobar Island. And Manipur bro antler deer, which is seen in the Loktak Lake, the world's only floating national park. And vultures, there are so many species in India, almost six species, nine species. And Malabar civet, Indian rhinoceros, Asiatic lion, swamp deer, Arbarasingha, Jedan's courser. That is, I have marked this asterisk symbol, no? That is for indicating the entire species are found in India. We will see about these on daily basis from tomorrow onwards, okay? So, next. So, in the previous current affairs, we have seen that four new species have been added by National Board for Wildlife. So, it is mandatory to see about, that is, read about the National Board for Wildlife. It is a statutory body under the Wildlife Protection Act 1972. It is advisory in nature. Its primary function is to promote the conservation and development of wildlife and forest. Its power is to review all the wildlife related matters and approve the projects which are in and around the protected areas, especially national parks and sanctuaries. And alteration of boundaries in national parks and wildlife sanctuaries will not be done without the approval of NBWL. So it is needed and must to read about NBWL as of now. Okay. So next one is composition. It is chaired by Prime Minister. It is so important. It is a mammoth body consisting of 47 members, and 19 members are ex officio members, and other members include 3 members of MPs from 2 from Lok Sabha and 1 from Rajya Sabha, 5 NGOs, 10 eminent ecologists, conservationists and environmentalists. There has been an issue around the National Board for in its membership, that is while participating in standing committee in discussions. So it is important. So the next one is tardigrades. They are microscopic earthlings, that is organisms, and they survived a crash landing on the moon surface by the ISRO. Because of that probe, they came to know about these organisms. They are found in terrestrial, marine and even in freshwater from Arctic to Antarctic. Now all the types of climatic conditions they can survive, and also at greater depths and altitudes also they can survive. They can survive in all the extreme conditions. They are microscopic, multicellular and most durable forms of life because they can live without food and water for almost a decade. And they are also known as water bass or moss piglets because they look like dirt in appearance. And we can see the tardigrades in Ant-Man and the Wasp movie, if you have noted in Avengers series, okay. And it is capable of surviving temperatures as high as 150 degrees Celsius and as low as minus 272 degrees Celsius. And they can withstand near zero pressure also in the outer space. They have witnessed this during a space probe in moon. And extreme radiation also in heat and coldest temperatures without food for a decade, almost decades. While reading about this, we have to read about Israel's Bereshit probe also. It is a private mission to the moon by Israeli non-profit space IL organization. It was successfully launched on board from Falcon 9 rocket from Cape Canaveral. And it arrived the lunar orbit in April 2019. At that time only they have found about the tardigrades. So while reading about that, also read about our New Space India Limited. I have already. So thank you for watching. Subscribe to App IAS channel. Till then, stay positive, stay healthy, keep smiling, be happy. Nandri.